All I want to do is listen to the video and then get out. You know what, I would move past a bit. You know what, we caught one of these too.
O'Brien. O'Brien, are you there? O'Brien? God damn it. I'm getting tired of being your errand boy, O'Brien. I guess I'll come back here and finish burning this infestation zone later.
Deke, you gotta hurry.
Ricky, what's going on?
That guy we've been looking for, Eric Lynch, who murdered Campbell and Reed at the farm.
Lynch, man. Son of a bitch.
You know where he is?
Yes, he's on the north shore at the old boat launch. Schizo wanted to go after him, but Iron Mike said to get you.
I'll get to him.
Thanks, Deke. Hurry.
I have Matthew 2 in the corner, so we're going to get Matthew in the corner as well, too. I've got a few hours to install those doors, because if that crack on, do what that needs to do. Now we're going to go and check on Boozer.
I don't know about you, but I could use a hand.
You lay down.
Thanks, ma'am.
He can't have visitors just yet, but I could really use a hand.
Okay, I'll see you later. I'll be here. Hey, Doc, seriously, though. Will I be able to play piano after all this is over?
Very funny, William. Lay down.
Okay. I can play chopsticks. No, seriously, I could. I'd be like...
As you can see, he's gonna be just fine. His fever's completely gone.
Good, that's good. All right, well, I gotta go take care
Deacon,
of some shit.
Like I said before, William really does owe you his life.
Boozer doesn't owe me shit, I owe him.
Hey, I saved two more. Eddie and Mia would have died without those antibiotics. I just thought you should know.
Seems like he's getting better.
Alright guys, we're gonna go and look at Boomy now. Hey guys, welcome back. How you doing? Welcome back to Day Gone. And yeah, today we're gonna be kicking down a kind of motorbike. Yeah.
Eat them alive.
How's it going, Lynch man? What, is the camp not feeding you well enough?
Fuck you!
Thought you just kill a couple guys right off with our shit? Don't matter if a bunch of folks here die of starvation because you got what you need, right?
Get off of me, you son of a bitch!
Hey, listen to me. Rick is gonna send some men for you. You tell them where you stash the seeds. Maybe they'll just shoot you, you know, instead of hanging you slow. What do you think about that?
I don't know what the hell you're talking about!
Okay, man, suit yourself.
Ricky, I got him, and I'll send you his position. Send someone out here to pick him up.
Does he have the seeds on his bike?
No, I didn't see him.
All right, we'll bring him in. Lost Lake out.
See you, Lynch man.
Right, I'll back.
Hey, I got a job for you.
You got a job for me?
Yeah, there's a bunch of dead freaks. The west of the footbridge stuck in the muck. I need someone to pull them out and take them to the burn pile. Got it?
Marsh duty.
Yeah.
Get someone else. I'm busy.
Hey, I'm getting you to do it. I don't know what Mike told you on your little field trip, but we got work to do. Here.
Hey. Schizo, he can't come with you, he's coming with me.
Last I checked, I wasn't talking to you.
Well, I checked in with Mike. I gotta go into the shit, and he's coming with me. All right?
Like I said, I'm busy.
And when you get back, you come find me.
You coming?
Where?
Doesn't matter.
Seriously, where are we headed?
North.
Ricky, I don't have time for your crap any more than Schizo's.
Come on, I'll show you. Mike told me what you did.
I didn't do anything.
About how if we seal the caves here, we can stop the hordes.
Never said it would stop them. Maybe slow them down. Look, are you going somewhere with us?
Yeah. I just thought that maybe you decided to stay. I mean, not just because of Boozer, but because you wanted to help.
Is that what you thought?
Hey,
back in the day, I did my share of runs.
You did, but never anything more than that, and you know it. So now you're helping Iron Mike seal the caves? What did you want me to think?
Okay, I got to the fork well, running a bit. Just a couple of minutes.
See, a few weeks back, we lost a man when this went down, shutting down the infirmary's respirator.
Respirator? Oh, God, Ricky, look around. If you're on a respirator out here, you're already dead.
What if it'd been Boozer? Yeah, that's what I thought. See, we haven't had power for almost 2 years, but the transformers and the lines, they all check out. Well, at least they do here. I want to ride up north, check out the hydro dam, just to see why it shut down.
Oh, no. Riding escort, that's Schizo's job.
I don't need an escort. You lived up there, you know the area better than anyone. Deacon, you asked for my help, right? Now I'm asking for yours. Okay, good. I'm gonna go grab some of the guys
that
can rut.
No, you're not. No, we're going in quiet. We're running to Copeland's men. I can handle them, but that wilderness up there is crawling with rippers and scumbags and God knows what else. More men, you know what that means? That means more attention. No, no, we're doing this my way.
Shit. Fine. Okay, let's go.
Look, Ricky, I gotta ask you. The other night, in the infirmary,
would I have shot you in the face? No.
Really? Oh. From the look on your face, you...
I would have taken you outside first and then shot you in the face.
Okay, so you wouldn't, you know, want to get blood all over the infirmary.
Uh-huh, exactly.
Okay, that guy's going to follow Ricky, and we're going to go and do her plan, but doing it my way. And I also got Mafia 2 installed, so yeah, we're going to be doing some of that as well.
If we get an early start, we can get back before dark.
As long as nothing goes wrong.
Well, what can go wrong? Following you?
Yeah, guys, Ricky's gonna follow me.
Just follow the route that I marked on your map. There's some marauder camps up there we want to stay away from.
Yeah, got it.
So how did you end up out here? I never asked you.
Same as everyone, I guess. When shit went down, I was 100 miles from home. The time I got back, everyone was gone.
Where are you from?
Grew up in a little town outside of Portland. Would work in the city, couch surf, go home on weekends.
Big city.
Yeah, right. Only in Oregon.
What was it like over there? I mean, how did you get out?
I don't know. Luck, I guess. Roads were backed up all the way down the coast. One giant parking lot. Willamette Valley was a war zone. Everything happened so fast. I told my friends to get out when I left. I don't think they listened to me.
I heard they nuked it.
Portland? Yeah, I heard that too. Don't think it's true. We'd be feeling the fallout, right?
Yeah. So, you and Addy.
You got a problem?
Me? No. Come on. I didn't know. You rode with us a long time. I guess it never came up.
I was like you. Seemed like, I don't know. Keeping your distance was just a good way to stay alive.
Okay, look, I shouldn't have asked. None of my business.
That's why I'm at the camp. You know, chance to live a normal life again.
Good luck with that.
It's nothing serious. Me and Addy?
Didn't look that way to me.
Yeah, well, things happen fast these days. You know what I mean?
Didn't ask. I wanted to tell you something.
Shoot.
Look, I appreciate you going to bat for me. For me and Boozer. With Iron Mike, I mean.
Wow, you are getting soft.
Fuck off.
You've never thanked me for anything.
Yeah, well, maybe I never had any reason to.
Okay. So where'd you and Iron Mike go the other day?
Wait, you said that he already told you about it.
He was pretty tight-lipped. I've known Iron Mike a long time. To be honest, I don't think I've ever seen him so, I don't know, depressed. Where'd you go?
Sherman's camp.
I heard that place was a freak show.
It is. But we didn't have much of a choice. I had an idea about sealing the caves, keep the hordes from coming through. He knew where the mining claims office was. We picked up some maps. He's gonna track down some explosives.
Your radio must be broken. Almost sounded like you volunteered for some shit.
I'm riding with you now, aren't I? Jesus.
He just wanted out of marsh duty.
Okay, you got me.
So what happened? Something happened.
Nothing, Ricky. Nothing happened.
He didn't say anything?
No, nothing happened. And no, Iron Mike didn't say anything. Like you said, he's a pretty tight-lipped guy.
Yeah, guys, we're just following Ricky. We're following Ricky to the dam.
All right, dam's coming up. take it slow near the gate. No idea who or what might be living there.
Got it.
Looks clear.
Are you expecting trouble?
Yeah, always. And if we run into any, we're gone.
All right, come on. I want to check the outflow.
Where are you going?
Down here.
No. Hey, this isn't right. There should be more water flowing out right there.
Yeah?
Yeah, and you hear that?
What?
Exactly. If the turbines were running, you'd be able to hear the hum of the lines from here. Oh. What happened there?
What? Oh. Same thing that happened to all the bridges. Smart men in uniforms decided blowing them up would keep the hordes from coming in.
Hordes of refugees or hordes of freaks?
Well, you figure men like Copeland? Probably both.
All right, come on, I want to check something out.
Doug, I should walk in the Vicky at the dam and again, I hope we find out a water flow like that. Going all the way to Teddy. And also getting close to Matthew too as well. And also, I hope you guys are. Some people are doing it, Dr. Scobby. It's kind of acting more doper than you think it is. More better than you think it is. So yeah, we could grab a few more books and like some comics and stuff. And I think Mafia 2 will help us boost that up. But yeah. Don't have to ship if you don't want it, but it'll be good if you did. And you get more support for our channel. And you get more data coming out quicker after the end of the day. And you'll get more matches as well. So yeah, that's a bonus for you guys. Some parts of yeah.
Come here, touch this. Come on. Okay. You feel anything?
No.
Exactly. If more water was flowing, the turbines would be vibrating. Come on.
Up this way. We're going all the way up to the top, up there.
Following you.
See these pipes? They're called the penstock. Water pressure builds up from the reservoir and is pushed down through the pipes, concentrating the force of the flow, which goes right through to the turbines.
How the hell do you know all this stuff?
I had two older brothers who were always fixing cars and shit with my dad. He got me a job at Boeing when I was only 17. I was going to school part-time to become a mechanical engineer when shit went down.
Did you ever see him again? Your dad, brothers?
No.
Yeah, guys. I just have to look you out.
Come on, over here.
Helping with the water and the dam so we got, so we can help last week.
Alright, let's figure this out. Well, this is gonna be fun.
So now wait, what's going on? What are you doing?
We only rode together a few months, but in all that time, I never saw you volunteer for anything. One of us has to jump down there and clear the intake. So, I'm up. Oh, but you can stand and Watch. Okay. Well, it's now or never. Let's go.
Power to port jump. Power to port jump.
Yeah, it's pretty mucked up. I think I can clear it, though. Run back down to the turbine. See if it's vibrating at all.
Hey, that guy could be walking down the deck. I want to find out where I need to go. I need to go somewhere over here. Come on, keep going, keep going. Oh, yeah, guys. I'm going to drop the water pipe in. Then do the flow.
Nothing. Wait a second. There it is. Yep, that did it.
Ha ha! You feel that vibration?
Yeah, but the power lines are still dead.
What? Man, oh, it couldn't be that easy, right? All right, come on, let's check out the transformers.
So, your dad and your brothers, what happened to them?
I don't know. On my way back, I tried calling over and over. I always got a busy signal. By the time I reached the house, it was deserted. The entire neighborhood was deserted. There were flyers everywhere, evacuation orders. I went to the closest refugee camp, but it was overrun. Everyone was dead. Freaks were everywhere.
Jesus, Ricky, I'm real sorry.
Yeah, it was a long time ago.
Yeah, guys, we're broken. We're looking for the turbine. I mean, the power flip. Could be just the turbine, you know, what a spell, but you know, just coming out now. Look at that, look at that.
But these are the ones feeding the lines going south.
All right, any idea what's wrong with them?
No, not a clue. Okay. Well, it might be a short in the turbine junction boxes, so let's just go down and check it out. Okay?
All right. So, what's with you and Schizo? I mean, it seems like you're always on the verge of ripping his throat out.
A few months back, Eddie and I caught him hiding outside our cabin while we were bathing.
What? He's a peeping Tom.
I told him if it happened again, he'd find out that my gun is bigger than his.
Jesus. You know, if Addie was there, Schizo probably wasn't looking at you.
It was all I could do to stop her from neutering the bastard.
Ouch.
Right? Never piss off a woman who knows how to use his gun. Here, boost me up.
Get it.
Okay, got it.
There. Here, I got the gate. Come on, junction room's right around here.
Thank you, Ricky. Thank you for opening my gate. That helped you hop over.
Oh, God, what is that smell?
Freaker nests. From the smell of it, more than a couple. Stay close.
Molotovs you got with you?
Enough.
Okay. Remember the drill. You light them up, I knock them down.
It's been a while, but I remember.
Light her up.
Burnett, ready?
Oh, yeah.
You good?
Yeah. They really don't like visitors much, do they?
Well, can you blame them?
Whew. Well, they better get used to this shit. You know what? As of today, I'm claiming this for Lost Lake Camp.
Power to the people.
All right, let's check the junction boxes and get the hell out of here. This is it. You ready?
Yep.
Okay. Damn. Yes! Houston, we have power.
Nice work.
I couldn't have done it without you.
Come on, let's find something to block the door in. I don't want to have to come back up here every month to clean this shit out.
Wait, wait, wait. You're gonna be here in a month?
What? No, I don't know. Would you just... Jesus.
I'm just fucking with you, Beef. Come on. So, why'd you ask about my dad and my brothers?
I don't know. He just, you never mentioned him before, so, you know, I'm sorry if I... If it's something you didn't want to talk about.
Oh, it's fine. In fact, it reminded me of something I wanted to ask you. We're riding together.
Okay, Ricky. Ricky, not now. You can ask me later.
No, hey. Hey.
Come on, we gotta get moving.
Hey, you never asked why I stopped riding with you and Boozer.
Was I supposed to ask? I already knew why. Iron Mike's bullshit. God, Ricky, do we gotta do this now?
We had been riding together for, I don't remember, a couple months. Come on.
Okay.
Okay. There was this one night, and I remember it really clearly. It was snowing outside, and Boozer was snoring. Remember how he used to snore? I swear, I thought he was going to bring a horde down on us,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, that pretty much hasn't changed.
Anyway, you thought everyone was asleep, and you were sitting outside by yourself like you always did, and you were staring at something. You didn't sleep the whole night. Let me see the photo, Deke. Come on, please. This is when I knew.
What'd you know, Ricky?
That I didn't want to end up like so many of us here. We're trapped in the past or running from it. I want to look forward. Okay, not back.
This isn't what you think it is, okay?
Get low! You're on the back! Find them!
Are you sure it's them?
I saw the mark on his back!
We're from Lost Lake Camp. Iron Mike has a treaty.
Well, that was a really good idea. You want to try that again?
Yes.
Why'd you break it?
Stay put.
Stop.
You've been a camper.
Shit. You assholes are kind of far from home, aren't you? Drag your asses back to Iron Butte and find the shithole you crawled out from!
Ah, shit! Come on, Iron Mike has a treaty, goddammit! Listen to me, we're from Lost Lake! We have a treaty!
Far north, aren't you? Huh? You don't want to get too far away from Carlos, do you?
Stay put and keep your head down.
Hey, I can take care of myself.
You're gonna camp on
me. You are not free! Then I'll just go straight to hell!
Yeah, nice and close to you, fucking, huh?
Done.
Stay put. Keep your head down.
Hey, I can take care of it. Stop.
Yeah? How long have you been a camper?
Show him the power.
Free!
Free! What are you doing? Reload!
Stay put. Keep your head down.
Now. Stop.
Yeah, I'm not gonna get over it.
Taking fire.
think that's the last of them.
Jesus. I've seen rippers before, but not like that. What the hell are they amped up on?
No idea. Back in the day, dealt with a few tweakers who acted like that. I think they're on PCP or whatever that other issue is.
Oh, bath salts. Remember? That was becoming a thing before everything went down.
Right, yeah. Come on, let's see if they messed up our bikes. What do you think that Iron Mike's treaty with these bastards is gonna hold?
I don't know.
Fucking rippers, after what they did to Boozer's arm, after what they did to Dick! Lisa, what?
This was clutched in one of their hands. What happened? Did you guys have a run-in, you and Boozer, with the rippers before you stole the antibiotics?
Well, I don't know. Look, whatever Carlos thinks I did, ain't gonna compare to what I'm gonna do to him if I ever see the son of a bitch.
Come on, let's go.
Stop you?
How'd you end up in the MC?
It's a long story.
We got a long ride.
Okay, I was a member of the 10th Mountain, part of a forward unit working with the Northern Alliance.
Shit, I didn't know you were in the Army. Why were...
You want to hear this or not?
Sorry.
We were advancing on Mazar-e Sharif. We got ambushed by a group of Taliban heading the other way. And they were in flatbed trucks, decked out with ZU-23s, modified anti-aircraft guns.
Big guns?
Yeah, really big fucking guns. Our Humvee exploded, went over a cliff, right into the Hari. You know how hard it is to drown in Afghanistan? It's hard. The place is one giant goddamn desert. Anyway, I was thrown clear, and when I came to, the Humvee was upside down in the river. I swam out to see if anyone survived. I pulled a body back to shore, and I did that 7 more times. And by the time I pulled in Tanner, my Sarge, I was done. And when I came home, I don't know, I bought a bike, spent a couple of years on the road, just moving from place to place, and,
To farewell? You grew up around here, right?
Yeah. Okay, so by the time I finally settled down, I got a job at a bike shop run by this old guy named Jack. And he ran the club. The Prez, that's what we used to call him. He patched me in himself.
Wait, Jack, I remember who you're talking about. He was in prison or something.
Some bad shit went down and he ended up taking the rap for the club.
Sounds like you guys were pretty tight.
Let's come back in the morning. You can get whatever tools you need, and we'll finish it up then. There'll be fewer freaks out.
So no hot shower tonight? Okay, but I want to show you something first.
Ricky, it's been a long day.
Come on, you know a lot about the freaks. I just want to show you something you might not know. Come on, we're out here anyway.
Shit, okay.
Let's go.
Can I ask you something?
God, like I said before, could I stop you? I don't know what you mean.
I mean, why do you still wear the cuts? You and Boozer, it's not like you're trying to recruit anymore or staking out territory.
No.
A couple of guys I worked with at the plant wore colors on the weekend. I asked them about it once. They said they wore them as a way of saying, fuck you, to, I don't know, cops, authority, the government. So what are you rebelling against?
whatever's left.
Look, we wear them because we wear them. What do you want? I mean, no idea about Boozer, but I ain't trying to say shit. It's just... Cut? That's who I am. I've done a lot of stupid shit in my life, but joining the MC, well... Let's just say that it's one of the few...
Ricky, what are we doing here? I've seen the Nero death trains before, and hordes.
I know. Not like this.
What the fuck?
Watch. I've come out here a few times to see them. They stay in these old machine buildings, and they come out every night like someone's ringing a dinner bell, right? When it's morning, they go back inside and what, hibernate?
You mean you never went down there to see?
Uh-huh. No. One time I got way too close, and a dozen of them started chasing me. It's like poking a hornet's nest. Come on, let's get out of here. It's getting dark.
Hey, where the hell have you been all day?
Nice to see you, too.
Yeah, well, Schizo said you and Deacon took off, and I was worried.
Addy, I'm tired, okay?
Oh, that's rich.
Hey, Dee, thank you.
Yeah, well, just let me know when you're ready to tackle that transformer. I'll be around.
Sure.
It's bullshit.
What is your problem?
No, no! What is your problem?
I just said, I'm tired. That's it.
Okay. I'm sorry. Like I said, I was worried. It's not like you to just take off without talking to me.
Okay.
So that's it?
Ago, we were up by Crazy Willie's, just scavenging, you know. I thought maybe the...